So, good morning students. Today I am going to deal with the topic that your science first chapter, that is the food and where does it come from. So today's our topic is food. Today's our new chapter is food. Where does it come from? So, we have tried different dishes, right, in our daily life, from starting from the breakfast, lunch and dinner. So, we have in breakfast, we usually refer to poha or upit or idli dosa, some light dishes, right? And after in the lunch time, we have chapati, vegetable, dal, rice. Okay. During night also, we have some different dishes like when chapatis, vegetables, we prepare some non-veg, vegetables, right? So, we have number of dishes in our daily life that we consume. Okay. Why we consume food? For the energy purpose and to work, right? So, as we have number of dishes. So, which usually prepared by our mothers. Mothers prepare lots of delicious and varieties for their family. Okay. So, let's take the example of the rice. So, we are taking the example of the rice. For the preparation of the rice, what all things your mother takes for preparing rice? The first is rice, then water and the salt. So three main items she used to take for preparing the rice, right? So for preparation of the rice, she used to take what all things? That is rice, water and salt. So, how she cooks the rice? So, she is to take water and put the rice particles. First, before cooking those rice, she is to wash that rice seeds and then put into the water and put some salt. Okay. So, after boiling of the rice into the water, and with some salt, so your rice gets ready. So your boiled rice is ready, right? So here the each substance, that is rice, water and salt, are the individual ingredient. So we use the term ingredient. So in simple terms, you use the term substance or the materials, right? But the particular term is that is ingredient. So rice is one ingredient, water is one ingredient, salt is one ingredient. So three ingredients are needed for the preparation of your rice, right? So this was about the ingredient. So different ingredients are needed for different preparation of the dish. So we can take the preparation of chapatis, vegetables. For a chapati we need what? Wheat flour, some salt, water. Okay. So there are some ingredients. And for your vegetables, your mom is to cut some vegetables, different vegetables. Okay, for the preparation of vegetables, what you need? Vegetable, vegetables oil, salt, then chili powder and some amount of water. Okay, for preparation of individual dish, we need different types of ingredient for the preparation of whole dish or a particular dish. So, we need different ingredients. Okay. So next, moving to the, so as they have given your page number first, that is food items, roti, chapati, what we need, atta and water, dal, we need different seeds or the pulses, water, salt, oil, spices, right? So they have given some of the examples of chapati and dal, how to prepare these dishes with the different types of ingredients. So you can try different dishes and what all the ingredients needed for that preparation. Okay, that was the ingredient or the substance needed for the preparation of a particular dish or the food item. So now moving to the next part, that is the food material and sources. So according to you, what all the food sources we have? So how we get the food items? So we have two main sources which provide us what materials for the preparation of the food, right? So what are those sources? First is plant source. Second is animal source. So we usually get the food materials from the two sources. That is, first one is the plant source, second is the animal source. So according to you, what actually plant produce and give us to us as a food? So we have what? Fruits and vegetables. As we get the fruits, vegetables and different kinds of seeds, right? So these are produced from where? Plants. So plants are the essential source of the food. So they give us what? Fruit, vegetables and pulses, cereals. So pulses, cereals we use for the seeds, right? Different kinds of seeds. And we have the animal source. What animal source, from what material we get from the animal? So we get different kind, like we have the milk. So we get the milk from the animal. Then we have non-veg material, like so we have the eggs, then meat, chicken. So as we consume these non-veg things, right? So these are from the animals. Okay. We have two main sources, that is plant source and animal source. Plants we get fruit, vegetable, seeds, and in animals we get milk, egg, then meat and the chicken. So what is the use of milk? So maybe you are knowing that from milk we can prepare. What we can prepare from the milk? So through milk, what all things we can prepare? Curd, cheese, ghee, right? There are some few items you can prepare from your milk. That is a curd, cheese, ghee. So we came to know that the two main sources are plants and animals, which give food to us. And after that getting, we just cook them. Okay. First it was in a raw form. After that we just prepare in the form of a food or the dishes. These are the two main sources. So before production or before getting fruits and vegetables or the seeds from the plant, what a farmer does? So what does the farmer does? So we have different, so we have fields, right? We have fields or the farms. We have the fields or the farms. We have the fields and farms where a farmer used to sow seeds in the soil. Okay. We sow seeds in the seeds into the soil. What happens? We water those seeds. Watering the field. What does the farmer do? Sowing the seeds into the soil or putting the seeds into the soil and watering those seeds into the field. After what happened, as the days pass, so what happens, these seeds gets converted into plants, right? So they gets converted into plants, and plants produces the fruit seeds, right? Fruits, seeds and vegetables. Okay, so farmer is the main person who produces the food articles or the product. So what he does, he sow the seed, then water those fields or the farms. After few days we get different types of fruit, seeds and vegetable. So this was the plant source. Okay, so as we know, animal sources, what? Eggs, milk, butter, cheese. So meat and eggs, so all these are animal products. So we have plants and animal products. Now, so as we have done with the food materials and the sources, now moving to the next part. So let's take some, before going to next part, take some the example of idli. So idli is a one type of a dish, right? So how it is getting prepared? Through dal. So first I will take the example of kheer. What for making kheer, what we need? For making kheer, one we need milk, then rice, and third one is the sugar. Okay, so for the preparation of the kheer we need milk, rice and sugar. So now understanding what are the sources of these ingredient, individual ingredient, right? So milk is what? How we get the milk? From the animal source, right? So animal. What about the rice? So rice are grown by the farmer in the fields. So these are the plant products. What about the sugar? So you get the sugar from the sugar canes, right? So it is a plant product or the plant source. So we have three main ingredients for the preparation of the kheer, that is milk, rice, sugar, and we have written sources. So from which source we are getting the milk, rice and sugar? So milk we get from the animal, rice from the plant, and sugar from the plant. Okay, so you can try with the few more examples of the dishes. Okay, okay, let's move to the next part, that is the plant part and animal product as a food. Okay, so what are the different parts of the plant we have? So what are the parts of the plants? So we have different parts of the plant, right? So first one is the flower. Okay, flower, fruits, leaves, stems and root. Okay, what happens. So more than if we consider we have different parts of the plants. So sometimes what happens, only one part of the plant is edible. So what do you mean by edible? Which we can eat, okay? So which is benefit for our body, okay? So edible means which we can have or eat, okay? So for sometimes what happens, only one part of the plant is edible. For example, a flower may be edible, or a fruit is only edible, or sometimes leaves. Okay, in leaves you can consider about the leafy vegetables, okay? So only leaf part of that particular plant is edible. That is the leafy vegetables are the leaves. Then in different fruits you can take, we only eat the fruit part, right? So mangoes and apples, all these are, so fruits are edible of that particular plant. And sometimes flowers, okay? And some roots are, only roots part are edible. Okay, so one part is edible. But sometimes what happens, more than one part of the plants are edible. Okay, more than one part of the plants are edible. So if you consider, like sometimes, if you consider one single plant, so flower, fruit may be edible, or leaves or fruit are both are edible. Okay, so we take, so in your textbook they have given the example of mustard seed. So seeds of mustard plant gives us oil and leaves as a vegetable. Okay, now mustard plant. So we have taken the mustard plant. So it is a single plant, right? So we are consuming what? Two parts, like seed and what they have given? Leaves. So, leaves. Seed as a oil, leaf as a vegetable. So, as they have given two examples, example of mustard plant, that is, from a single plant we can use one or more parts of the plant as a edible. Edible means to have or to eat. So mustard plant, from the seed we can get the oil, and from the leaves we have the vegetables, right? So we can prepare vegetable of that leaves, and from the seeds we get the oil, okay? Whether you are understood what I am saying, that from a single plant to we can say one or more parts of the plant can be edible. Not only a single part, more than one is edible part. So edible means to have or to eat. Okay, so you can try some particular dish, right? So they have given about the brinjal curry. Brinjal vegetable, right? So how we prepare the brinjal? Okay, so for preparing brinjal curry or brinjal vegetable, you need brinjal, right? Then chili, that is chili powder, oil. Okay, oil. So as they have given, how we make the brinjal curry or the brinjal vegetable. Hey, for this we are needed brinjal, chili powder, oil, and the salt, and you can say some water. Right. So for a brinjal curry we need brinjal, chili powder, oil, salt, and some water. So brinjal is what? Which part of the plant? So it is a fruit. Brinjal is what? Fruit. And chili, this is fruit only. So chili means a fruit. And oil is a the plant and a seed part of the plant. So two parts of the plant are used for the preparation of the brinjal curry. So you can try with some other examples, right? So brinjal, chili, oil, salt and water for the preparation of brinjal curry. So you can have with some different examples for the preparation, right? So what all the things we have studied in this class? So first part is, so today we have studied about the ingredient. Second is sources of food. Third is the parts of plant. Covered the, that is, ingredient, source of food and parts of plant which are edible. Okay, so on the first part, that is the ingredient. Ingredient is what? A substance or the material which is needed for preparing the particular food or the dishes, right? Then second is what? Source of food. So we have two sources of food. So which is that? Plant source and animal source, right? So plant source and animal source. So what we get from the plant? Fruit, vegetables and what? Okay, so fruits, vegetables we get from the plant. And what about the animals? We get the egg, milk, meat, chicken. So whatever non-veg part is covered under the animals, whereas the source of food in case of plant, what we get? That is fruits, vegetables, right? And even the seeds. So seeds is used for the preparation of what? Your oils. Okay. And parts of the plant which are edible. So what do you mean by the edible? So edibles are what? To have. So edibles means which we can have or we can eat the things. Okay. So parts of the plant, we have different parts of the plants, right? Leaves, fruit, flowers, stem, leaves. Okay, branches, roots. Okay, so what happened? More than one part of the